outlets like BBC, CNN, and Al Jazeera carried breaking news segments covering the situation in Japan. Analysts emphasized the importance of earthquake-resistant construction, pointing out that despite the strength of the tremors, Japan's advanced infrastructure prevented far greater destruction. Hospitals prepared for incoming patients, treating those with minor injuries from falling objects and collapsed structures. Emergency shelters were opened for residents whose homes were damaged. Community centers distributed food, water, and blankets, reflecting the solidarity and resilience of Japanese society in times of crisis. Seismologists confirmed that this earthquake was part of a series of powerful undersea movements along tectonic plates that have historically triggered some of the strongest quakes in the world. They warned of further possible aftershocks in the coming days. The situation remains closely monitored, with scientists providing constant updates to authorities and the public. Despite the chaos, many stories of heroism and kindness emerged. Neighbors helped each other, strangers shared umbrellas in the rain as they evacuated, and schools organized safe zones for children. These moments of unity highlighted the strength of community bonds in Japan during emergencies. The world continues to watch as Japan recovers from yet another reminder of its position along one of the most seismically active regions on Earth. International leaders expressed support, while humanitarian organizations offered assistance. Experts stressed the need for preparedness, not just in Japan, but across all nations vulnerable to earthquakes. For now, Japan stands shaken but unbroken. The nation once again shows its remarkable resilience, facing nature's fury with discipline, courage, and solidarity. A series of powerful underground tremors and strong earthquakes shook Japan, leaving millions of people in shock and fear. The ground trembled violently in several regions, with buildings swaying, bridges rattling, and alarms sounding across multiple cities. People rushed into the streets, seeking safety from the shaking, while emergency sirens echoed in the background. According to local authorities, the quakes were felt across a wide area, with the most intense shocks recorded in coastal regions and densely populated urban zones. Many residents described the sensation as a never-ending movement of the ground, followed by smaller aftershocks that continued throughout the day and night. Television channels such as NHK, ANN, and Nippon TV interrupted their programs to broadcast live coverage of the events. Cameras captured tall skyscrapers swaying, shelves collapsing in supermarkets, and commuters trapped in halted train systems. The atmosphere was tense as reporters provided continuous updates and rescue teams worked under pressure. Hospitals across affected prefectures reported an influx of injured citizens. Emergency medical staff worked tirelessly to treat people suffering from fractures, head injuries, and shock-related symptoms. Temporary shelters were quickly set up to provide refuge for families who could not return to their damaged homes. Experts explained that Japan sits on one of the most seismically active zones in the world, making earthquakes a constant threat. Seismologists warned of possible aftershocks, urging residents to stay alert, keep emergency supplies close, and follow safety guidelines. Scenes from major cities such as Tokyo, Osaka, and Sendai showed thousands of people gathered in evacuation centers. Some areas experienced power outages, with lights flickering and entire neighborhoods plunged into darkness. Local authorities worked quickly to restore electricity and water supplies, but many families spent the night without basic utilities. Dramatic footage showed streets cracked open sidewalks lifted and water mains bursting, flooding certain districts. Highways were temporarily closed as engineers inspected bridges and tunnels for potential damage. Airports suspended operations for several hours to ensure the safety of travelers and staff. Despite the fear, Japan once again demonstrated its resilience. Citizens showed solidarity, helping one another during the crisis. Volunteers distributed food, blankets, and bottled water to those in need, while rescue teams searched tirelessly for people who might have been trapped under collapsed structures. International media outlets such as CNN, BBC, Al Jazeera, and Reuters quickly picked up the story, highlighting the scale of the seismic activity and the rapid response of Japan's disaster management agencies. The footage spread around the world, with millions following the update in real time. While the full extent of the damage is still being assessed, officials have confirmed that recovery efforts are already underway. Structural engineers are inspecting schools, hospitals, and office buildings to ensure safety before allowing people to return. Government leaders have pledged full support to the affected regions, emphasizing the importance of unity and patience during the difficult recovery period. In the coming days, the focus will shift to rebuilding and ensuring that critical infrastructure remains stable. The earthquakes have once again reminded the nation and the world of the unpredictable power of nature and the importance of preparedness in the face of disaster. A series of powerful underground tremors and strong earthquakes struck Japan, leaving residents in shock and fear as buildings swayed and emergency sirens filled the air. The seismic activity began early in the morning, with initial tremors shaking coastal cities and small towns. Many people were awakened by the rumbling sound that echoed across neighborhoods, followed by the rattling of windows and furniture. Authorities immediately issued alerts, warning citizens to stay vigilant and move to safer areas if necessary. As the morning progressed, stronger earthquakes followed, shaking skyscrapers in Tokyo, Osaka, and other major metropolitan centers. News channels broadcast live footage of swaying high-rise towers, cracked walls, and fighting cars in open spaces. Reporters described chaotic scenes as train services were halted, power lines were damaged, and transportation hubs were brought to a standstill. Local news stations highlighted how schools, hospitals, and government buildings activated emergency procedures. Students were evacuated to sports fields. Doctors and nurses prepared for an influx of injured people, and officials coordinated responses from disaster management centers. The continuous aftershocks made the situation even more tense, as residents feared further destruction. Television coverage showed roads with deep fissures splitting across highways and bridges being inspected for structural integrity. Firefighters, rescue teams, and police units were deployed to ensure public safety. In some areas, gas leaks were reported.